There are many who believe that this disease is God's vengeance, but I believe it was sent to teach people how to love and understand and have compassion for each other. If you do not know who GENA TEW is, begin that journey with this video and work your way back to this video so I don't ruin your initial impression of her. Now, if the devil places his followers in certain positions,
I think it's official. The devil loves me, y'all.
It is becoming crystal clear that GENA TEW is a follower he is using to further spread AIDS. And I say that with malice, envy, and arrogance absent from my heart. The hurt I felt when I first watched this video was real and still feels real. Keep in mind, I was still hyper ignorant to the fact that AIDS was no longer a death sentence. I thought I was watching someone waste away because of a deadly and disgusting disease. I'm sorry, GENA TEW, but your actions disgust me. Watch this clip and let little old ignorant me know why it was important for you to wear those little underwears. Yellow beat. And then had the nerves to address the quote-unquote briefs. Whether that was a pad or not, it is unacceptable for someone with AIDS to promote sex the way you do. What made you record that?
The devil.
I'm not asking you to be Arthur Ashe and use your final days to bring attention to AIDS so people like GENA TEW could get better. Wouldn't we have expected these actions from Charlie Sheen?
Yep.
Well, even Sheen is a spokesperson for condoms and a public advocate for safe sex. Safe sex for GENA is nothing but an afterthought.
Or just be smart and use a condom.
Or be smart when given advice, or should never precede be smart. Dirt. That should be the first, if not only, option. But keep in mind, y'all, she is doing the devil's work and I'll prove it. This is the gesture for I love you. And this is the gesture to signify an allegiance to Satan. GENA TEW's sister recently passed before all of this took place. They say when someone sells their soul and get what they want, they have to give up someone they love. Would she be living the way she is living if it were God fueling her?
Nope.
Would she have posted that she would continue to listen to devil music no matter what anyone says if her fuel was God?
Nope.
Would she have made a TikTok saying raw sex is worth AIDS?
Nope.
I'm not speaking out against you because I want you to live your life in the closet like Liberace or Freddie Mercury.
You guys, we did it. I finally bought my house. I'm so freaking thankful.
This disease is giving you everything you were struggling to receive. Fame, money, and
all of my little fans.
Being that they're gifts from Satan, I truthfully fear the impact you will have on our future children. Maybe COVID forced you to come out like it did Billy Porter, and you really had no intention of coming out. But like Robert Mapplethorpe, you turned the camera on yourself. We were expecting someone that understood the position they were thrust into, but we got nothing more than a greedy, attractive
devil worshiper.
She makes me disgusted, y'all, and I will forever speak out against her actions. She alleged she was raped on multiple occasions. She says she may have received a tattoo from an infected needle.
Sarah!
GENA, how come you never mentioned drug use with dirty needles?
I object, Your Honor!
To yourself?
Yeah.
GENA TEW even mentioned in this video she was dating a guy that was actively having sex with men for money.
Man booty.
Pardon my ignorance, but it seems like she was doing everything possible to get AIDS. Receptive anal intercourse and insertive anal intercourse is the top two ways to transmit HIV through intercourse. How does a person that goes through any of those situations not get tested for every single thing in the world? That's included
emotional damage.
Okay, I've been needing to get on here and say this because I've been realizing I haven't said it on the video yet, but I am undetectable, you guys. That means untransmittable. So, you know, with that being said, people are asking me, well, are you gonna marry or have a baby with someone with AIDS? I don't need to marry somebody with AIDS. They don't have to have AIDS. That means I cannot transmit it to the other person. There are precautions that a man can have. They could take things like PrEP. It does have a little complications with that, I believe. So I'm not recommending it, but you could, you know, just preventative, you know, precaution.
She's trying to justify her reckless lifestyle, but y'all tell me if y'all believe her.
I can have a normal life. Let's get rid of that stigma.
Pedro Zamora could ask for the removal of that stigma because he was at least going to churches and schools, handing out condoms and spreading awareness of AIDS and HIV. GENA TEW's actions are starting to make me dislike her. A person with HIV can sleep unprotected with someone that does not have HIV. And because that person with HIV says she or he acts responsible and takes all of their meds, we sane folks should believe they cannot transmit that disease to us.
What
in the world is going on here?
Why wouldn't that encourage the infected to remain silent about their infection?
That's dirty.
I've met two people in my life with AIDS. Both people were infected by their spouses. As of 2022, 35 states have laws that criminalize HIV exposure. GENA TEW's from
Memphis, Tennessee, born and raised,
which is one of those states that will criminalize her actions. So she dipped.
Moved to Ohio. I was there for like 2 years.
That is also a state that will criminalize her actions. So she moved
to New York. I lived in New York for 4 years, trying to pursue music, of course.
Which doesn't seem as strict if you blindly read their penal code. But upon further review, you'll notice that intent isn't needed to prosecute a person that transmits HIV to another person.
Gotcha.
Meaning, if GENA TEW infects someone, do not pass go.
Go straight to jail.
So you know GENA was out of there.
Then my manager was out in LA, so I ended up moving to LA. I stayed in LA for 4 years. Then I got sick.
Cali's laws protect the infected.
If your significant other infects you because they are sleeping around, you would have to prove in a court of law that your significant other intentionally infected you, which can be impossible to prove. The law was more than likely introduced to protect the person that accidentally infects another person because they were unaware they themselves were infected. But to leave a law open so people that are HIV positive can sleep around infecting people, claiming they thought they were undetectable and being absolved of their crime, is literally insane. Back to the beginning, GENA needs to be careful because she may infect someone unintentionally, which can still be considered negligent homicide. I do not know what y'all are talking about when y'all say let her live her life, or when she says she can live a regular life. It doesn't work like that. If you contract AIDS, you're out of the game.
Period.